girls. Thank you for joining us for Hips and Thighs of Steel 2000. I'm Lisa Hart, and I'd like to introduce you to Tracy York.
Hello.
And Michelle Nevidomsky.
Hi.
As your Platinum Series team, we've dedicated ourselves to perfecting a program to trim and tone every muscle of the hip and thigh area, including your buns. Even during the low-impact aerobic portion, we'll give you exercises guaranteed to give you definition.
Absolutely. And what's unique about the Platinum Series team is that each one of us gets to teach you our most favorite and effective exercises. Now, they're challenging, so pace yourself and feel free to take a break if you need to.
And each one of our routines gives you a complete hip and thigh workout. So build up to all three, or if you're short on time, just choose one.
Now, our safety cues are very specific, so pay close attention. We'll educate you about the form and purpose of each exercise. Keep water close by. You'll need to rehydrate frequently. And every workout should begin with a warm-up. Tracy has one plan that will definitely get your muscles ready for action. You ready, Tracy?
I sure am ready. Are you ready?
Let's get going.
Let's go. Come on.
Let's go, Tracy.
Okay, let's get you warmed up and ready for our workout. Are you ladies ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, easy arms. The arms go up slowly to the side. Bring them around the front and down. Now let's take that a little faster.
It's up. Great.
Just big rhythmic movements to increase the body core temperature and get you ready for your stretch. The heel for 4, 3, 2. Now I want to see a march. Here we go. 4, 3, 2. Are you doing this march? Now it's heel. 2, 3. Now the march for 4, 3, 2. Now 3 heels. So 3, 2. Now march in the center. Left,
wow.
Right,
switching sides.
Yes. Fine. Now arms go back in. I know. A lot to think about. Let's give it a try. Take it up. Shoulders, roll those shoulders back. Now let's add some movement to this baby. Come on, I want to see it.
You got it.
And now we move back. 2, 3. Let's try that one more time. And then guess what?
Put it together?
We're going to put it together. That's right.
You got to come.
Here we go. Listen up. It's 1, 2, two steps to the right. And 1, 2. Now I'm going to add some easy arms. You'll like these. Yes.
Now, Michelle, aren't you using this step later?
Yes, I'm going to do it in my aerobics section so you already learned it.
Right. See how that works? We're teaching you a lot of things you're going to use later. Now, all the way through. Up, side, around. Okay, now the step tap right here. Reach. We'll call this Michelle's part.
Michelle's tap.
Michelle's tap. And out. 2, 3. Let's do this 2 more times. 1 to each side. I think they're ready to move into their stretch.
I'm getting warm.
Okay, reach out left, right. I want to see it. Nice long lines. Chest up. Bending those knees from side to side. Now hands to the thighs. Keep the lunge. 3, 2 more. And then we're going to move into that nice back stretch. Now round, push the navel up.
Right time.
Okay, 2 more. Hands right here for support. 1 more time, I want you to push all the way up. And now just taking it to the right, up and down. Moving into our calf stretch, pressing that heel down. Now give me a big old bicep curl. I want to see those arms flex and push that heel down.
Look at those biceps, Tracy.
You got the nice ones. Now hold it. Hold it here. Right here, you want to keep the heel pressed down, and we're stretching to reduce your risk of injury. Now lift up, tilt tailbone down, lower down and up. So we're not so much stretching to increase the flexibility, just to prepare you for your workout. 2 more, and 1. Now take it down and hold it. Keep those arms there for support. Thanks, Tracy. Great warm-up. Now keep up your march. Let's pick up the intensity level just a bit. Your first step is a V step, and we do so by stepping out right, left, center, then switch. We'll start it out slowly. To your right, step slow. So it's right, left, and then we just switch our lead foot. We're going to pick up the pace. Right side, step
okay.
out.
Yeah,
let's get moving.
Oh,
work. All right. We're also changing our body level. So it's lower and lift. And the next time you go to the right, I want you to lift your right elbow up. Then your left, right here, to shoulder level. It switches the same as your legs. We're still lowering and lifting, taking it to the side. Now once more each direction. Then I want you to hold it in a march. Get ready.
I already feel my buns.
Me too. Right, good, march it out. Next, we're gonna work your buns more with a right and left lunge and four marches in between. Lunge to your right. Four marches.
Oh yeah.
Lunge side.
Yeah, that's what I tell
four
you.
Four marches here. Now listen up. Knee stays in alignment with the ankle. Other way, push off your heel. Now arms push in the direction of your leg. Push it.
Oh, those arms. Your arms. These are Michelle's arms. She likes these. She works it.
I do.
You got it.
Get home. Pose. And once more to this side. And guess what? From the top.
Hey. Okay.
Do that again. And get ready.
Lunge.
Right lunge.
Okay.
She's got it.
Woo!
Concentrating hard with me. Lunge it out.
Have to.
Pump it. Right and left. And cup your march.
I am starting to sweat.
Let's take it from the top. Once more.
I
again.
Want to see that personality. Come on. Let's work it.
And lunge. Take it out. Four marches. Last one. Side to side. And get ready. I want you to stay here. Hold your march. Next, there'll be three marches and one tap right here. March, two, three, and tap. Then we're going to move these three marches and one tap forward and back. Let's go.
Come on, Laura.
Catch up with Lisa.
A little bit
of fun. Now, next time you go forward, I want you to lift your knee. Put your knee here. Again. Now, we're going to turn this knee out to the side. Push your shoulder, arms up. So you push it, and arms
feel that
up.
Intensity.
Let's do this two more. Here's your last one. Now listen up. Hold here, lift your knees, arms alternate. Two, three, four more, then we'll walk up. Six, seven, put it together with your walk. Let
yes.
me see it.
Right.
Woo, four knees this time. Arms alternate.
Work it, Lisa.
Walk it up. Have a little fun with it. Four knees. Once more.
Oh, I think there's going to be something more.
Hold that, too. Now I want you to squat out to your right and left. Squat to your right. You got it.
Every
stay in. Now push out from your shoulders with your arms. Pull it in.
Great yeah. exercise.
Once more each way. Now let's put that together with the walk.
Okay.
Walk forward. Now you know this part. Make it good. Make every movement count. Squat to your right and left. We do this again. And walk forward. Make it good. Press it up.
I think Tracy likes this walk.
Knees.
I feel like I'm going somewhere.
Squat to your right and left. And listen up, girls. Let's take it from the top.
Okay.
Put it with that V.
Okay.
One time each side. And lunge it. March here. So we're working those hips and thighs, as well as conditioning your heart. Pump it here. Burning lots of fat.
Oh, I like that word.
I like that too. Squat out. And V. Lunge it. Now next time we take it from the top, we're going to break it down a bit. Lunge it. Now walk up. Next there'll only be one V step. And one lunge, no march. Squat.
Oh, I feel that combination.
Okay,
you ready?
Okay. Right. Lunge it. Now walk straight up.
Right
foot.
Oh,
like
I got
that.
You.
Yeah. So we've taken out the march, and that's it. The rest stays the same. Pick it up. Squat. Now get ready. V right here.
Oh, yeah.
You got it.
All right.
Walk up. So now we get to try all this on the other.
other side, finally.
Hup. Feels good. Get a little balance.
Want to your left.
Let's do it again from the top.
All right,
woo. Here we go.
All right. Let's see it. Make every movement count for you. You are doing a great job. You're going to feel wonderful about yourself. Squat. Let's take it to the other side.
Your friends are going to notice.
You got it.
Gosh, you look so good.
What have you done? That's right. And we've worked hard to get where we are, too. Take it from the top again. Now's your time to have a little fun with it.
Woo!
We are.
Right, Michelle? Great combination, Lisa.
Not good if it's not fun.
That's right.
Come on.
And it's fun.
Squat.
And
here it is. You know what to do.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. Stand with us. Walk it up. Lift your knees. Arms alternate. Pump. And squat.
I think we can do it one more time to each side.
Let's do it.
Make it good. Push. And lift. Ready to squat. Make it good. This is your last one. March it out.
All right.
Woo!
Keep up the heart.
Thank you for sticking with me. Now, Michelle has got an awesome aerobic program for you. You ready, Michelle?
I'm ready.
Let's do it.
Okay. Let's keep that march up. Legs are lifted. Okay. We're going to keep that intensity up. I want you to take it out to a wide march and give me a step tap. Here we go. Step tap. All right. Now, I'm going to go back to a step that Tracy did in the warm-up.
Okay.
It's just three step taps and a grapevine. Okay. Let's try it now. It's three, two, give me a grapevine left. Right there. Three step taps.
You know this one.
And grapevine. I think this looks familiar to you at home, too. Okay, let's do this one more time. We're going to add in the arms. Here we go. They just swing side. Now, up over the head. Big arms.
Oops. Yeah, lots
of energy. Make those arms strong. Lift.
Big sweep.
All right. Good. Take it up and lift. All right. One more time because I know you have this. And I want you to go into three knee lifts and two walks. You're going to get ready with your left knee.
Right here.
Left. And walk. Right knee. Perfect. And
I
walk.
Got that march.
Yeah.
Yes. He's got the walk.
That's it. Pick those feet up and walk.
Walk like you're going somewhere.
That's it. Let's try this again. What we're going to do is add some arms in. I want you to give me a real strong bicep curl right here. Squeeze those arms.
Check it out.
Open out center. Three. I think I brought my peanut gallery with me today. Push out center. Okay. I want to see this one more time. I think Tracy and Lisa need to move their biceps a little harder.
Oh, okay.
Come on. From the top. Are you ready?
Yes.
Let's do it.
Here we go.
And circle up. The fun part. This is the fun part, yes. Here we go, here's the knees.
I'm ready.
Three, push, and walk.
Yes.
Okay, I wanna do this one more time.
All right, let's go.
Big old sweep.
Woo!
That's it. Okay, here's those knees.
All right,
biceps, work.
Pump it,
push out,
pull.
Yes, okay. And swing it out. Now next time, we're gonna take the walk, and we're gonna move it back behind ourselves. And walk to the center.
Okay.
Get ready. To the center.
No problem.
Yes. We're gonna try this one again. Knees up. Let's try again.
Now she's really
walk backwards. Move. Turn your shoulders to the side. One more time. Let's try again. Turn side. And walk. Are we ready from the top?
Okay, let's go.
Okay, swing it out. Good. And go. Lift. All right.
Really fun, Michelle.
Oh, good.
Like
I'm glad you like it.
Walk it
back. Woo! Give me a little attitude there.
Yes.
A little style. And swing.
We gotta work this now.
Come on, girls.
Yes.
Really work at home with us.
No excuses.
Knees up. We know it. this part. Let's swing it out. And this is the last time. And I want to add on to this. We're going to do alternating tap outs, starting left and right. All right, so here we go. Left foot tap out. Yes. Good. Let's do a few more of these. Keep the knees soft. Four more. All right. Let's do a double left.
This is the easy part.
Single right here. Four. Let's do a double. You'll really feel this in your quadriceps and your thighs. And single.
Okay.
And your glutes.
Out of break.
And double. Now I want to add some arms in there. So let's do a tricep push down. Here's the double. We're working the front of our arms on those biceps. So now we got to work the back.
I'll do it.
You'll do it?
Complete arm.
Let's break this in half. We're going to do single, double.
Perfect. I like the music.
I like that. Wasn't that nice? Let's do one more set of these. Then we're just going to go into an alternating knee lift.
Okay.
We're going to start left, right.
All right.
Get right here.
Here we go.
Okay. Up. Yes. Chest is lifted. Abs are in. Let's just punch the arms out.
As usual. That's it.
Oh, wait. Good. Are you ready to go back to the tap out?
Okay. Let's try
okay.
it.
Okay. Single, single.
All right.
Oh, yeah, double. One more set. Now we have 8 knee lifts.
Yeah.
Punch out. Punch. Strong. 6, 5. Yes. Good.
Do it. Tap outside.
Let's do that again. Double. I think you should count with us at home also.
Yes, it really helps.
Right, knees up. 8.
Yes.
It feels so good just to relax.
Turn out.
Let's break this in half.
Okay.
Single, single. You're going to lift your right knee up first.
All right.
Okay. Getting ready.
Back to the tap out.
Oh, perfect.
And I got this.
We got it.
Single
down.
Up.
Okay. I'm going to do this one more time on each side. Then we're going to take it back to the top. And when we take it, it's going to be broken down in half. Take it out.
Okay.
So just listen up. You'll be fine.
Okay.
Get ready.
Ready.
We trust you.
Swing it out.
Okay. Your knees are going to come up right here. Knees up. Knees up.
Good.
Fit together?
Yes. Nice.
Not bad, huh?
Walk
tap out.
Tap. One. Okay.
Okay.
Two.
Yes. Knees up. All right. Let's try again. Now you know it.
Yes.
Really work it. Use those legs.
Move.
Knees up. Push. Push those arms out. Tap out.
Yes.
Don't burn
it. Bend those legs.
We're really burning fat now. Last time like this.
All right.
And swing up. Back. Tap out.
Yes.
Yes.
I'm feeling something else is going to come.
I mean, you know what? I want to do it just one more time like this. One more time. Just to make sure.
Okay.
Okay.
That's
all
right.
Nothing wrong with doing it again. Push out.
Ho.
Yes. And knees. Now, I want you to come back to a march. March it out. And Lisa's going to check our heart rates.
That's right. Now's the time to check yourself. Check your intensity level. You should still be able to hold on a conversation, and if not, you may be working out too hard. Take your hands down to your waist and keep up the legs, or if you feel like you need more of a workout, put a little bit more step into it. Thanks, Michelle. Great workout.
Okay, so now we have Tracy, so hang in there. Keep moving.
Take it, Tracy.
I'm going to give it a little more step. Come on, march right, left. Right, left. Right, left. Yes. Now, if you're feeling a little tired, I want you to dig deep down inside and find the energy to work out with us for just a little bit longer. I'm going to teach you a new step. It's just going to be double step, march, march, double step. Here we go. It's double, march, march, double, march, march, double. Now we're going to travel with this a little bit. We go a little right and a little left.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Now let's really move with it, and we're going to shuffle step behind. Yes.
This does move. I like this.
Come on. This guy moves. Let's get four more. Then we're going to alternate knees and march in place. Ready?
Ready.
Here we go. Alternate. Okay. Step. Knee. Knee. Now stay here, march for 4, 3, 2. Try that again. And guess what?
What?
That shuffle step comes right here, right where we're marching. Here we go. Alternate the knees. Step. Knee. Knee. Now little shuffle step.
All right.
Shuffle step.
Nice, Grace.
Now, we'll help.
easy
and back.
Go.
Yeah.
Right to the shuffle. Okay, one more. Step knee, and then guess what? I get to show you some arms.
All right.
Okay, arm push up. Step knee, knee. Now really pump it right here. Get those knees up. Come on.
A little step, but it's really worth it.
You bet. Would I give you anything less than that?
That's right.
Okay, now no arms, hamstring curl.
New muscle group.
Because this is hips and thighs. Good. Again, hamstring. One, two. Little step behind and shuffle. Now the arms just match the legs. Right here. Good. Now pump those arms. Oh, Michelle, you're looking good back there.
I'm pumping back here.
What about me? Okay. I told you that right at the beginning. Now, new muscle group. Step side. Side, side. Same thing. You're just changing the direction of the leg, and you're also utilizing different muscle groups. Come on, one, two, three. Now arms go out. Come on, nice and strong.
This is my favorite.
Thank you.
Let's go on you.
Outer thigh.
We all like that outer thigh, upper hip thing. No.
Okay, guess what? One of each. Knee, hamstring, and side. Come on.
All right.
Okay, that works great.
This is when it really counts. When you're saying, oh, I can't possibly do another minute. And you do.
She was reading my
mind. We can do it. We can do it.
Okay, one more set on each side. One more time right here.
Uh-oh.
Now listen up. One more time. And we're going to add on. I want you to get ready. Step touch. Forward and back. Right, left.
Okay.
Right here. Step touch. Right, left. Now I want you to step right. Kick left. Give me a march. Are you ready? In four.
exercises.
It sure does. It must just feel so nice.
It does.
Okay, now I want you to press all the way up. Bring your feet about hip width apart. Step back with your right.
Arms go all the way up.
Pressing back through your heel and feel that stretch through your calf.
Yes.
Now lower down. I want you to bend that rear knee. Tilt the hips downward. Hip flexor.
Wow, yeah.
Now we're working a little bit more on our flexibility. You'll notice we're holding the stretches a little bit longer. Breathing. Fill your body with oxygen. Let's go to that hamstring stretch.
It's all the way down my calf.
Doesn't that feel great? Okay, let's go right to back to hip width apart. Press up. Step back with the other foot and lift those arms all the way up. Feel it. Pressing right back through that heel. Down. Bend that knee. Now lower directly downward. Tilt the hips right here. Wonderful. Now our hamstring stretch.
Great. You're going to need this stretch. I'm really going to work your legs.
You are. That was the first
time. I believe you.
Now, if you don't have carpet, now's a good time to maybe go get a mat. Bring your feet about hip width apart. You might want to put your VCR in pause. Take your feet about shoulder width apart. Get some water. Exhale. You did a great job.
Fabulous.
Just keep filling your body with air. And get ready for Lisa.
Now, for your first toning segment, we'll be standing. So take your feet about hips distance apart. Contract your abdomen in towards your spine. Point your tailbone down towards the floor, tilting your pelvis slightly forward. This is your neutral position. Now, I'm going to take you through a series of lunges and squats to work your total hip and thigh area. For your lunge, let's take your right leg forward. Lower your body down, keeping the knee in line with your ankle. Now, to come back, we push through the heel. Come back always to your neutral position. Let's try it to this side slowly. Knee in line with the ankle. Push up and back to neutral. 8 single lunges and take it forward. Alternating each time. Remember the knee stays in alignment with the ankle. Abdomen stays contracted inward. Counting down. 2 more. Now, 2 single lunges right and left. Then we're going to add 1 slow right here. Here's the pace. Down. 2, 3, 4. Contract. 2 singles. Press. Now remember, you don't have to step out too far. And lift. How you doing, Tracy?
Well, I'm working pretty hard. These are great exercises
for your legs.
One of the best.
Contract as you lift. 2 singles.
You really feel it right away.
That's
right.
That. All right. This is your last slow one. And 1 single lunge, 1 squat to the side. Other way. So when you're in that squat, your weight stays evenly distributed. Abdomen contracted inward, chin and chest stay lifted. Looking good.
Now those tips are important because you have good form. It helps you exercise correctly.
Pay attention to those safety cues. And I find myself as I get tired,
yes,
letting go of my abdominals.
And last 2. Last 1 this side. Now I want you to squat out to your right and then lift this leg. Bring it back in, other side. So we're out, starting to work that outer hip area. It's your gluteus medius, also known as your abductor. Press it down and lift. All right, 4 more. Control it. Don't try to rush these. Lift, strong press, 2 more. Then we're going to take it from the top. Get ready for your 2 single lunges, right and left.
Oh, here we go.
Combination.
I know.
Even in the toning, I like those combos.
Slowly.
And lift. 1 single lunge, 1 side squat. Now keep it out here. Lift the leg from the top, right here. Left side goes forward.
I like that variation.
Single, yes.
Slow. 1 single goes forward.
Yes.
Get ready to take it to the side. Back out there. And lift, make it good. 2 singles. Right here.
Good. Keep coming back to that neutral, huh?
You got it, always. Concentrate on that. Contraction, single, and take it to the side. You are doing fantastic. Back out, leg lift. Ready to take it over here?
Yeah. Okay.
One. Go. 1 more. Here's your slow pace one.
I really feel this.
Okay. And single forward. And side. All right. Now we're going to keep the squat out to the side. Hold here. Turn your toes out slightly. Take a deep breath. Inhale up. And exhale, take it down.
Nice little break.
And take a little break. Now, lower your body down. Contract the abdomen in. Tailbone pointed down towards the floor. Neutral position. We'll take it up for four and down for four. Let's go. Contracting the whole way up. Three, four, and down. Let's do that one more time. Then we'll be going up for two and down for two. Last four, three,
stretch.
Up for two, down for two. So it's a contraction all the way up, stretch all the way down. Now listen up. Remember that slow lunge forward? Two more times. We're going to take it forward and then all the way back, and we'll do a pulse lunge to the back. Up for two and down. Now bring your feet in and think about it. Slow lunge. Let's go. Slow and sweep. Press back. Pulse down.
Okay.
Two, three, again. Sweep, lift, press back, pulse down.
Yes.
And again, sweep it, lift all the way back.
Feeling
just got to do it one more time on this side. Last time.
Leg.
Uh-huh. Squeeze.
Oh, yeah.
All right, get ready. And switch legs.
Here we go.
Forward. Make a good sweep. Press.
Yeah.
Pulse. Contract. Again,
keep those abdominals.
Right.
Yes.
Sweep it all the way back, pulse down.
Squeeze your buttock as tight as you can.
And two more times.
Oh, we can do this, don't give up.
Sweep it, make it controlled. Contract.
One more
time. All right, got my counters back there. They want to make sure I don't make them do any extras. And release it. Take it, inhale, back to that plie position. And let's take it up for four and down for four. Let's go. Up for two, three, four, and down.
Stretch it on the way down.
Last time up at four.
Squeeze the thumbs on the way up. Those inner thighs
contract
together. Yes.
Next we go up for two and down for two. Let's go. Up for two. Now this may seem like a break. We're still working.
Who said it seems like a break?
Yeah.
Like a break,
you know me. And take it in slowly, two times deep side. Take it forward. Let's go.
Sweep.
Take
down.
It
pump.
Forward. And sweep back. And pulse.
Okay.
Down. Two, three. Last time this side.
Okay.
Easy. And pulse it down. Get ready to switch sides.
Okay.
And
this is it.
Just
Let's
two more on this side. Think about how great your hips and thighs are going to look.
Press they are going to look great.
Stick with me. And just once more. Press it back.
Okay.
Contract. Six, seven. And knees apart. Knees stay slightly bent. Take a deep breath. Inhale. Now, Michelle has got an awesome leg workout for us. Are you ready, Michelle?
I'm ready.
Take it away. Uh-huh.
So now is the time to grab your towel or your mat if you need one. And we're going to take it down to the floor. So go ahead and sit down. We're going to further work our buns and our hips by taking it down into a side-lying position. Now your head is resting into your arm, which can be bent or extended. Your knees are at a 45 degree angle. Your abdominals are pulled in nice and tight. The most important thing is to keep those hips stacked, one on top of the other, and your free arm is resting out in front of you. Start by contracting your glutes, which will lift your knee up, and then roll it back down. Let's try that again. Contract the glutes. Then lower. Let's take this up to tempo. Lift and lower. And really make sure that hip is stacked on top of each other. Good. Lift up and down. That's it.
Feels great. It feels a lot different than what Lisa did.
Yeah, it sure does. It's a nice way to work the same muscle.
A little bit more specific move.
Good. Let's do four more. And three. Then what I want you to do is think about separating your feet. So here we go, separate your feet, lift down, just hold it here, then lower down. So you're gonna lift and hold for two counts and lower down. Think about lifting through your heel and releasing on the way down one more time. Next time we're gonna extend on the way up. So we lift
extend, lift again, then lower and bend.
Ooh, killer thighs.
Lift, extend, lift, lower and bend. That's it. Keep reaching out through the heels. And Dan, you feel this one right away. So we don't have to do that many. We're only going to do four more. Lift, up, and down. And you don't have to lift your leg real high. Up and down. Couple more. You're doing great. One
last
more time.
One.
I want you to keep that leg extended.
Okay.
Bring it halfway down now. Just lift up and down. We're not going to do that many, so just hang in there. That's it. Exhale on the way up. Just four. Come on, you can do it. Three.
Michelle, I'm going to get you.
I know. Lower that leg all the way down. Rope on
your backs. Good job, you guys. Now your feet are at a comfortable distance apart from your body and about shoulder distance apart. Hands are on the floor. And you're going to just rotate your pelvis forward. So squeeze your glutes in and then release. Let's do that slowly one more time. Really contract your buns in, then release. Take it up to tempo. Squeeze, release. Squeeze, release. A lot of times we think we need to keep our buns contracted the whole time. And it's really important that we release them on the way down. That's it. Your tailbone will come off the floor.
Yeah, that's okay. That's what we want.
Good, that's it. Just
contract.
Squeeze. Yeah. Contract. Really concentrate on this. Four more. And three. Good. Last two. Then we're going to take this into double time. So pulse at the top. Squeeze. Yeah. Really release each time. You've got to work into this. Concentrate. Really contract as hard as you can. Good. We got eight more. Lift. Last four.
Three.
Lower it down. Good job, you guys. Relax. Now just roll back over onto your side. And then you're going to sit up. And now we've got to go over to our other side lying position.
Leg.
Can't forget that. So, all the way down.
Head relaxing into your arm. Knees at a 45 degree angle. Abdominals in. Hips are stacked. Free arm is in front. Let's slowly rotate and down up to tempo. I know you know it. Lift and lower. Now, I really like these rotation exercises because I really feel it lifts and rounds your buttocks. I think we all like that.
Yeah, we all want that round booty.
Good. Up, fitting those jeans nice and tight. Lift. Squeeze. Keep those hips stacked. Don't roll back. Up. Good, we've just got four more of these. And three. Good, remember, we're gonna separate the feet and hold. Here we go, separate the feet. Hold for two counts, lower down. Good, reach out through the heel and lower down. Just two more. And we're gonna add that extension back in, so get ready for it.
Are
you ready?
Right
here we go. It's up, extend,
higher.
Lift, lower down. Up, reach that heel, lift, lower down. Keep those toes parallel, lift, lower down. Up, lift, that's it. Just four more, hang in there, really squeeze, contract, lift, and down.
Really focus.
Concentrate.
Just two more, hang in there, two more. Yes, and lift, one more time. Good, now halfway down, pulse it up for eight. Come on, seven. Do that many. Six. Don't give up here. I know you're really feeling it.
Stick with us.
Just four more. You can do it. Three. Two more. Woo. Now release all the way down.
Oh,
good job. Roll back
onto your back. We've got one more set of glutes to do.
Still got a little bit more work.
I remember this. Hands by the side. Ready? Let's pulse it up. Contract. Lift and down. Lift and down. That's it. Up. Remember, relaxing on the way down. Really squeeze in the center. That's it. Up and down. Now you'll feel a little stretch through your hip flexors as you come up. Good. Lift and down. Lift and down. Last four. And three. And I want to pick up the pace on this. Here we go. Lift it up.
Let's do it.
Squeeze. Squeeze.
We're almost
that's there. Concentrate. Make
hard.
This work. Tighten those buns up. That's it. Squeeze. Squeeze.
Keep it going.
You gotta keep it up. Four more. Three, two, and one. Relax down.
little back over to our sides. And we're going to sit up. Let's just extend the legs out. And now Tracy is going to further work your buns and your inner thighs. Now, I know these exercises are challenging, so stick with us because believe me, they work. Let's continue working your hips and thighs, but I want to put you in a different position. So what I'd like you to do is come over onto your hands and your knees. Now you're going to bring your knees about hip width apart, and your elbows are going to be just slightly in front of your shoulders. You want to find a comfortable position right here. The abdominals are contracted, and your head is in line with your spine. Now here's the really important part. We're going to extend our leg, and we're going to make sure that our hips stay squared and rotated down to the ground so we can effectively target our gluteals. Now we'll slowly bring the heel in, and then we'll press out. We'll try that again slowly. In. Now let's go to tempo, and you're going to bring it in and press. Okay, now you're constantly readjusting that hip. How you doing, Lisa?
Is my alignment okay?
Yeah, it looks good. Rotate a little bit farther down. There you go.
Okay.
See,
yeah.
When you rotate upward and you lose it, we're getting that medius, the portion that Michelle just worked. So we want to get a different portion of the gluteal. Good. Continue. Four more. Now press back like you're closing a steel door with the heel of your foot. And now relax. Hold it. Bending the knee. We're going to rotate inward. It goes in. Bring the knee down towards the calf. And press back up to neutral. Let's do it again. It's in, down, press back up. Now I want you to readjust and make sure those hips are squared to the floor. Are you with me?
Okay,
yeah,
I'm
really
ready.
Have to concentrate.
I've got it.
Keep the hips squared. See, technique is going to make all the difference. You could do 100 of these with bad form. But if you do them right, you're going to see results. And here, press down.
And if you do them right, you don't have to do as many.
That's yeah.
Right.
And I like that.
We like that. Good point.
Okay, one more. Rotate inward, pressing back up. Oh, you did a great job. Now we've got the other leg, so let's really concentrate. We're going to extend that rear leg. Again, adjust the hips so the hips are square to the floor. And we're going to pull that heel in and press it back. Here we go. It's in, press back. Now, if you'll notice, we're not throwing that leg up and behind us. It's going directly back.
So we're never arching our back.
No. You're keeping your abdominals contracted. And we're actually really focusing on the lower portion of the buns. So that gives you that nice rounded lower half. Good. Four more. Three.
Traction on the way back.
Two. Now I want you to hold it up, readjust, and just bend. We're going to do that little combination where you rotate inward, down, and press up. Here we go. It goes inward, down, press up. So we're incorporating a little bit of that inner thigh.
Yeah. And I really feel that. I think it's a great inner thigh exercise.
Yeah. Well, if you like this, you're going to like my next exercise.
Uh-oh.
Strictly inner thigh. Again, rotate in, down, and you press back up into our starting position. And again, keep adjusting those hips.
Almost there.
Oh.
Yeah. We've worked really hard, huh?
It's in, and down,
one.
Up. Fantastic. Take a break. Whew. Let's come over into our sideline position where you can extend your arm down or you can bring it behind you. This time, though, the bottom leg is straight. The top leg is up on the front. It might be more comfortable for you just to bring your toe because then your hips can stay stacked. You'll notice that Lisa has a little bit longer of a leg, so she's able to comfortably put her knee down. I keep mine up. Now, we're just going to lift and lower, focusing on the inner thigh. Good, I think that's three, four, good. Squeezing. Focus contraction right on the inner thigh. Now we're gonna slowly go tighter, tighter, really tight.
Okay, this is what she was talking about. We were just getting warmed up for this inner thigh.
And I think I figured out there's no way to cheat on this exercise.
You can't make it easy.
And if you do, I'm gonna have to come back there. Come on.
Make her get up.
Two. Three. Now each time you should feel the contraction get a little tighter, tighter, all the way up.
Good. Now what about our foot? Should we have it flexed?
Well, you shouldn't have a hard flex, but a comfortable flex. We don't want to have loose, limp feet. Nice and strong. Okay, now relax. You're done with that side, got it?
Got that other leg.
So come on up.
Excited.
Let's take it over to the other side. Side lying position. You can extend your arm if you want. Leg over the top, and you're just going to lift and lower. Now make the adjustments that you need. Your hips are stacked, abdominals in.
So we're completely...
Now we have the complete product of hips and thighs. We've gotten everything.
I think we've
now
every
angle. Up, up, and down. We've got inner thigh, outer thigh, quadriceps, hamstrings.
We have worked the total hip and thigh area. Just
two.
Like I promised.
Kept my word.
Up, two, three.
Great.
Lifting, squeezing, tighter. See, a variety of exercises is really great because if you do the same thing over and over again, your muscles don't respond as effectively after a while.
That's right.
Good. All right. Great job. Now, what I want you to do is just reach up and hold it. Just take a nice deep breath in and exhale. Now, you've gotten through all the toning work. You've done a great job. And now Lisa is going to take you through your cool-down stretch.
And after all that hard work, you need the stretch. And much more, you deserve it. Now is the time to relax. Let's take a deep breath, inhale. And exhale, release it slowly. Now take your top knee in towards your chest. Pull it gently in. And you can let your foot and your knee touch to the floor. Pull that knee in. And start to feel a stretch in the outer hip area that we just worked so hard. Now, if you're not feeling a stretch, you may need to pull it in just a little bit more. And as Michelle just said, you need this stretch. It is very important to stretch after every type of workout. Never leave that portion out. Just hold your stretch, relax. Now, let's take this leg back. Holding onto your shoelaces, we're gonna stretch the front of your thigh, your quadricep, and all through that front hip area. Don't want you to arch your back. Press into this hip area here. And just hold that stretch. Continue to breathe. And now let's extend both legs. Extend your arms up over your head.
This feels so good.
Long stretch. Take a deep breath, inhale. And breathe out. And let's take that arm up. Just a little graceful stretch. And extend it. Inhaling as you take that arm up. And exhale on the way down. Now what I'd like you to do is bend your bottom leg, pulling it in, and then gently lift yourself up to a sitting position. Take a soft flex with this foot, and now turn your body towards your extended leg. Sit up tall, and let's stretch over that leg.
Oh, that's so good.
I like this one.
Yes.
Now, what I want you to do is make sure that you're not rounding into it. If that's what you're doing, you may be trying to go over too far. You just need to go over till you feel a gentle stretch in the back of the thigh, your hamstring. Hold your stretch. Now, let's take a deep breath, inhale. Round up towards the center. And take the soles of your feet together. Now, we need to do a little inner thigh stretch because Tracy really worked our inner thighs.
I sure did, huh?
And you did a great job. You stuck with us. Now sit tall, take a deep breath, inhale, and let's lift those knees up a little bit, and then as you exhale, press them towards the floor. Now avoid holding tightly onto your feet, just a loose grip. Let's take one more deep breath, inhale, and exhale, press down, hold that stretch. And now, feet to the floor, soles of the feet, and just hold on behind your thighs. And sit tall, now let's take a deep breath, inhale. And as we exhale, we're going to round back, pressing between your shoulder blades.
I think this is the best one.
I think so, too.
Yes. Rounding your chin to chest. And take a deep breath, inhale. And exhale, take it down. You can tip your elbows up just a little bit, pulling your scapulas, your shoulder blades a little bit further apart, feel more of a stretch. And just release it. Relax every muscle in your body. Take it up. Now let's lay on down on this side. Gently take yourself down. Tall stretch, take a deep breath, inhale. And exhale. Now this top knee comes in towards your chest. Remember, you can set your foot and your knee down towards the floor. And gently pull that knee in towards your chest. And hold the stretch.
Remember to breathe. And let's take that leg behind. This is your time to really think about what you want to achieve in your fitness program. Hold your stretch. Remember here, don't arch your back. Pressing into this hip area. And let's take a long stretch. Extend your legs. Take a deep breath, inhale. And exhale, release it. Let's take that arm up. Nice soft line. Take it down. Again, inhale as you lift that arm up. And slowly exhale, take it down. Now we bend that bottom leg. And slowly take it up to a sitting position. Let's go right over to this stretch for your hamstring on this side. Remember to try and keep your back flat. Holding here. And take a deep breath, inhale, round it slowly up, and just sit in a position that's comfortable for you. You have just made it through a very challenging hip and thigh workout, and you are one step closer to those trim, toned hips and thighs you deserve.
And don't worry if you didn't make it through the entire program. Give yourself time to be able to build up and do all of the exercises.
And set realistic fitness goals. Never say you can't, because we know you can.
That's right. Do your Hips and Thighs of Steel program 3 days a week, and combined with good nutrition, you will get the results you want. Let's keep taking a deep breath. Inhale up, and exhale, take it down.